All right, you guys, thanks for joining me today. Today we'll be looking at keyless entry systems with our Flipper Zero, and we'll be scanning to see what we can pick up. These key fobs generally operate on a frequency of 315 megahertz in the US and Japan, and 433.92 megahertz in Europe, as you can see here. So today we're going to see what we can pick up with the Flipper Zero. If you have a Flipper Zero, you can use these settings to pick it up. If not, just watch it for the entertainment value. So you'll open your menu, go to sub gigahertz. Make sure you go down to read raw, but you want to change the configuration because right now we're scanning at 433. So you want to change your frequency all the way down to the bottom where it says 315. And change the modulation on the bottom to AM270. You'll start recording. Pick up a key fob that you know is working. Press one of your buttons. If it doesn't read, you can try another button. Obviously, this key fob has a dead battery. The one that I tested earlier was this one. So you can still see it's still reading. So if you press, you get a little spike on the graph. So what you'll do is you'll stop. You can either erase it if you don't want that huge long length before and after the signal. Erase it, make sure it's still in 315, record it again, then quickly push the button, stop. And there you have your one signal for the panic button. So now you can take this signal, save it, type in whatever you want to save it as, and then you can go to your save section. You can see I already have some. And you can actually deploy. You can send out signals with this to copy and mimic the signal of that panic remote. So what we'll do now, if we wanted to mimic that signal, we would hit send, and that is actively sending that panic signal, just like I'm pushing this button using this device. But as you can see, look at the light. It only broadcasts it for as long as your recording length was. So if you need one that's longer, you would have to record long, push the button so it picks it up, then record long, and then stop. So now I'll show you what happens if you get a partial reading on one of these key fob signals with the incorrect settings. So I'll show you first what happens when you have one that is correct. So if you have one that's correct, you switch to 315, AM270, and start recording. You can see, watch the little light down here. You get a spike, 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 spike. Now, that was on 270. If you have it set wrong, even if it's still on the same channel, 315, if you set it for something like FM 238, you're gonna get either partial or no reading. So see there, it got a brief one for the unlock, and it did get one for the trunk. So you're getting one for the trunk. You're also getting one for the unlock. But You won't get one for the panic, and you won't get one for the lock. Sometimes. Because they're operating on the wrong frequency modulation. So it's looking for something in a certain section here where it's not picking it up. Next, we'll try a different configuration. So try one on AM650, which I know works. To start recording. Panic. Good. Unlock. Good. Trunk. Good. Lock. Good. So, as you can see from that, as long as you stay within the AM band between 270, like we tested the first time, and 650, which we just now tested, you can see the difference. But if you jump over to the FM, you start losing the signal. So now we'll try the very last one on FM, FM 476. Panic. You have to hold it to get a signal. So it has to broadcast on that frequency longer. Do the unlock. You can see not every time is it picking it up right away. Try the trunk. See, some of the times that I push it, it's not picking up. You have to hold it down. I'll flip it around so you can see. See, sometimes it's not even catching the signal. So, what you want to do in this case is you want to narrow in which band you're searching on. So you go to your configure and just drop it down. There's only four options, so as long as you switch through all these and find out which one you're operating on, and then set the modulation correctly, you should be able to find whatever you're looking for. That's that. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you leave it a like if you did.